Hello friends, in this session we are going to discuss about the logical standby activity. So first is that securing the logical standby database is the first thing. So configure the database guard to control the user access to the table. So here what you can do, alter database guard commands keyword is there. When using this keyword on the SQL prompt, you have three options. One is a all, one is a standby, and one is a none. So what does this mean? Prevents the all the user from making changes to the any data into the database. So if you are using the alter database guard all, what does it mean? It is not allowing you to do the any kind of changes in the your logical standby database. Next, alter database guard standby. So it is preventing the user from making changes to the any data maintaining by the data guard SQL apply. So whatever the data are comes with the SQL apply commands, fine, means from the primary to standby using SQL apply architecture. So that data users are not able to change if you are issuing the command alter database guard standby none. That is the normal security. If you are issuing alter database guard none, that is the normal security. Okay, query the guard status in the column V dollar database. Okay, you can just check the status, whether it is a all, whether it is standby, whether it is a none. Fine. The database guard level is automatically set to all by the broker on the logical standby database. So it is by default, it's a all means prevent the user from making any changes to any data into the your database. Fine. And the database guard level applies to the all the user except the sys. Fine. So it is not going to be applied to the sys. Other than sys, it is applying to the all the users. Fine. So this is the first thing, that is you can just secure your logical standby using this command, alter database guard command. Next, automatically deletion of the redo files by the SQL apply. See, this is the files redo. Second thing, this is the redo log files you are receiving from the primary. It is generating the redo logs from the primary database. Fine. These redos are converting to the SQL apply, fine, SQL statement, and this is transforming to the SQL statement, and this is going to be applied onto the logical standby. So this is the your architecture. Fine. But here, once this SQL apply process is doing everything, means it is converting your redo to the SQL statement, and once the SQL statement is applied to the your logical standby, this redo log files which you receive from the primary, whatever the redo informations, archive log files, whichever you receive from the your primary database, which is not required. So what you can do, delete this redo log files. But after the how many days or how many time, what is the duration, like 60 minutes, 1 day, 2 day, 3 day. So that depends upon the parameters you need to set up. So let's see here, the log auto delete retention parameter target, this parameter you need to set up. Fine, is used to specify the number of minutes that the SQL apply keeps the remote archive log files after completely applying its contents. Fine. So this is the parameter is very important to deletion of the your archive files which you receive from the primary, whatever the redo informations you have. So specify the number of minutes that the SQL apply keeps the remote archive log files after the completely applying its content. So it automatically deletes the your redo information or archive log files from the logical standby database once it is applying to the your logical standby database, whatever the informations you have. Okay, is applicable only if the log auto delete is set to true. So first of all, you need to just set up these things, parameter log auto delete into the set up the true. And then the flash recovery is not being used to store the remote archive logs. And very important thing, your archive redo log files are not stored to the your flash recovery area on the your logical standby database. Then and then it is going to be deleted. So here has a default value of 1440 minutes. If you want to change these things, what you can do, execute these things, you need to execute on the standby logical standby. Fine. And here what you require, DBMS underscore logical standby apply set log underscore auto underscore delete and so retention target, that is the 15 minutes. So I am just changing from 1440 to 15 minutes. Fine. So this, in this way you can just change this minutes to 15 minutes using this PLSQL commands. Fine. So what happened after the 15 minutes, whatever the archive log files are there on the logical standby, that is going to be deleted. So let's see all this activity practically.
First thing is that securing your logical standby data. So configure the database guard to control the user access to table. Fine. So here the first thing is that alter database guard command, this is the keyword you can use, alter database guard. So here you can use the all, standby, none. Fine. So here you can just query this thing on your standby and primary. Here you can just execute the statement, select guard status. Fine, this is all. Fine, this is the guard status is all. What you can do, what does it mean all mine? Means prevent the user from making changes to any data in the database. Standby means prevent the user from making any changes to any data maintained by the DataGuard SQL API. Means whatever the data you are receiving from the primary, that you are not going to be updated, which is maintained by the SQL API process. All means you can't do the any kind of changes. And the none means normal security. If you want to change this thing, means all to standby, standby to all, how can you do? So here you can do for the your alter database guard standby. Fine, so you can just check the guard status from v$database. So fine, this is you have changed to the standby. Also from standby we can just make it to the guard all. Fine, so select guard status from v$database. This is all. Fine, so this is the first activity, that securing your logical standby database. Next activity is automatic deletion of redo log files by the SQL API. So whatever the redo log files you are receiving from the primary, that should be deleted automatically because that is no longer required once the SQL API is applying all the transactions to the logical standby database. So here for that, what you required? So here for that, managing the remote archive log file retention. So this parameter log auto delete retention target, that parameter you need to set up. This is basically used to specify the number of minutes that SQL API keeps the remote archive log after completely applying its content. Means it's like you can just set up this parameter to 30 minutes or the like 1440, that is for the 1 day. Fine, so that depends upon your requirement or depends upon your database configuration. You can just keep this parameter, and in future if you want to change, you can just change it also. Fine, so it is applicable only if log auto delete is set to true and the flash recovery is not being used to store the remote archive log files. Fine, so here how can you do this thing? How can you check whether the log auto delete is enabled or not? So here you can just check from the one dynamic performance view is there, select star from data dictionary is there, DBA_log_std by parameters where name like log. So you will get all the information. Fine, log, or I will just write down log auto delete. So here you can see the log auto delete. Fine, this is the true. Fine, so once it is true, then and then you can just change this log auto delete retention target parameter. And if you want to change it, fine, how can you change it? The default value is 1440. And if you want to change it, how can you change? I am just applying for the 15 minutes. So here after 15 minutes, whatever the redos are there, archives are there on the standby, that is going to be deleted automatically. Why? Because the SQL apply process within the 15 minutes apply all the transactions from the redo. So here I am just changing it to the your 15 minutes. PL SQL completed successfully. Fine. So this is done successfully. So in this way, you can just change the your log auto delete retention target parameter. So in this session, we have discussed about the different activity on the logical standby database. Thank you.